Today I'm going to show you some tips for the graph editor. Let's begin with the ways how to add new nodes into a graph. The first way to add new nodes is to use the menu bar. By default, it contains 7 menus that categorize the different node types. Add data contains nodes that import data into GiPipe or generate data based on parameters. The file system menu allows to navigate file system hierarchies and extract information from files and directories. Annotations contains nodes for processing or generating data annotations. Image processing functions are located in the Images menu. Regions of interest can be processed via nodes located in the ROI menu. The Tables menu contains nodes for table processing and plotting. Additional functionality is located in the Miscellaneous menu. On selecting an entry in the menu, a new node will be placed at the cursor. You can freely move this cursor by clicking in the graph area. Here I'm going to add the node Import Image that loads the provided files as images. Move a node by dragging them by their colored area. Create an edge by dragging a line between two slots to transfer data between nodes. The second way to add new nodes is to use the search bar. Select the entry labeled with Create New to add the node next to the cursor. If you are familiar with other visual programming languages, you maybe want a list of nodes that can be dragged into the graph. You will find such option next to the search bar. Here the cursor will follow your mouse while dragging the node. The last way to add new nodes is to use the algorithm finder. The arrow menu of each slot contains an entry called Find Matching Algorithm. Selecting this option shows all compatible sources or targets for our selected slot. Click the arrow button to add the selected node and create the edge. Finally, let's talk about some of the additional options you see at the top right. Next to the undo and redo commands is a way to control how the graph is displayed. By default, the graph is displayed in a vertical fashion. But if you prefer a different arrangement, select the horizontal view. The positions are stored independently from the vertical view, so feel free to arrange the nodes how you see fit. For the next function, I'm going to ruin the layout of my graph. Fortunately, I can use the AutoLayout function to tidy the graph layout. For the next function, I move the view far outside the graph area. To bring the nodes back into the view, use the Center View to Nodes command. Finally, you can also zoom in and out of the graph via the zoom controls you find at the right-hand side or by holding the control button and scrolling your mouse wheel. And that's it for today. See you in the next video.